Let's see how we can make evaluation. So from the dashboard that we are, we go to evaluation. From here we can see a map when we can put first the address of the asset that we're willing to do the evaluation. So for example, okay, so I've put a place in Thessaloniki, so it's an apartment, 100 square meters, construction year 2001, two spaces, second floor, condition good. So from here, the valuation model provides us with a fair value according to the data that we have collected over the years. So for acquisition price or for rent price. So this is the model valuation that we're doing. So let's consider that we want to do a more throughout valuation, a deeper valuation. We can do valuation analysis. Here we can see that we have a small dashboard when we can see the returns, the cash flows, depending on the scenario that we have chosen. This is the model rent value, transaction fees, and we can play as well with what we consider the true value for revenues, annual revenues for this asset. Also, we can see the asset and all the point of interest that are close. So depending on how significant we are considering them. Also, looking at valuation analysis, we can see comparable transactions. So this is ads that were posted like 20 days ago, 1 month ago, 16 relevant ads in the same area. So we can choose which of them we consider most relevant. Also with the rent, so comparable rents. So, and then we can get the average based on what we have selected. So now we have not selected the most representative. That's why we see bigger gaps between the model and the comparable prices. Lastly, if we want to do a due diligence, to do some actual services for this asset, we can ask for somebody to go look at the asset and provide us with some data.